All right, as a celebration in the way of the fifth day of the 75th anniversary of the World Economic Peace Treaty of Bretton Woods being promised to the troops 3 weeks after D-Day, I'll try and get this thing wound up. It's not copyright or anything. It's about a world economic peace treaty.
Roughly 400,000 millions. You could build 100,000 4 million houses and 100,000 each. Maybe your pension money was used to bankrupt your own country. Just have a look at the front page, maybe in Salisbury Library. February the 1st, 2019, 70, and you think it's a bit sweet. It's money from British banks and something funny called exchange rates. Maybe that's got something to do with moving money, which is actually against the world economic peace deal. Fresh onwards. And if you're stuck about regulation, why not ask a company like William Hill? They pay tax and they also are regulated. And saying that modern technology is a reason for breaking the world economic treaty is really rather silly, because it means that now everybody can have a go, and nobody's going to know whether we're going to have British pound becoming. Horrible history. Same thing happened in Venezuela. In Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, it became Who Wants to Be a Billionaire. Only thing is, you can't buy even a pack of Twizzlers with a million. Earlier. We have to conserve our resources, preserve the rainforests, don't spend all the money on gambling. The World Health Organization says that ecology causes a pandemic. The more pandemic you have, the more chance it is of an airborne pandemic. And for those who are tempted to say, oh, let's have a cow, we need a cow. No, we don't. What we need is higher standards of living and higher upward motion social mobility, just like in the 1950s and 60s, which means that some Scandinavian countries actually suffered from populations going down. Whoa! So, sharing isn't a bad thing after all. No, not a bad thing at all. Anyway, I've got the video, Press Onwards, United News. It's on YouTube, I've written some comments underneath. You'd be far better looking in the parliamentary records of all the parliaments in the world that agreed to it. Men like Winston Churchill, De Gaulle, Roosevelt, Truman, the Free French, the Free Polish, the Free Czechoslovakian, the Free Dutch, etc., etc.